At training sites all over the country, American athletes are in their Olympic countdown. Improving techniques, building stamina, and sharpening their skills. For those athletes competing in winter sports, this means getting ready for the 1980 Olympic Winter Games at Lake Placid, New York.
As a four-time member of America's Olympic ski jumping team, I know firsthand exactly how an athlete feels about his own performance. And I vividly remember my years of training, practice, and competition building to this one day's effort. This is an exciting time for me, for the Olympics are coming back to Lake Placid, where I have lived all my life.
Since the last Olympic Winter Games at Innsbruck, Austria in 1976, American athletes have been preparing, training, and competing in international competitions. To be good enough for the Olympic team, you must be the best, a national champion. It requires extraordinary dedication and commitment. Over the last few years, I've seen a direct parallel to the athletes' preparation. Lake Placid began an Olympic countdown in 1974, when it was selected as the site of the 1980 Olympic Winter Games. The theme of the town's proposal to the International Olympic Committee was an Olympics in perspective, a return to the original Olympic ideal that the athletic contests are primarily for the athletes. Lake Placid would retain its character, a small mountain community, and the athletes, not masses of spectators, would be the first priority. Even so, extensive new construction and modernizing of the area's sports facilities were needed. A new Olympic field house was put up alongside the original Olympic arena, the site of Sonja Henie's triumphs in 1932, and Dorothy Hamill's training sessions that led to her gold medal in 1976. Both arenas will be used during the 1980 games. Towering 70 and 90 meter ski jump ramps rise in place of the old ski jump facilities. Refrigerated bobsled and luge runs were installed on the site of the 1932 bob run. Competitors and 600 coaches and trainers will be housed in the Athletes Olympic Village. Alpine events, downhill and slalom ski races, will be held on Whiteface Mountain. Olympic skiers will race over improved trails now rated by competitors as equal to the best in Europe. since the overwhelming majority of spectators follow the Olympics through television and other news media, communications technicians played a key role in preparing Lake Placid for the Olympic Games. Television and radio coverage of Olympic events will be directed and controlled from the new World Broadcast Center. Then the signals will be sent to a communications tower on top of Whiteface Mountain and out to world audiences. Throughout 1979, Lake Placid was host to a variety of world-class competitions, a dress rehearsal for the town and the communications media. Worldwide interest in Olympic competition has brought about an explosion of media coverage. Television, radio, newspapers, and magazines report Olympic activities in depth. In fact, for almost everyone, televised programs of the Olympics are the Olympics. The immediacy and intimacy of live television reporting are responsible for turning the Olympics into a global media event, combining the ancient traditions of athletic contests with today's communications capabilities. And in 1980, with tomorrow's technology, laser-driven light wave signals developed by Bell Labs will carry network color TV programming for the first time in a commercial application of this technology. Although the town's size and character are basically the same, Lake Placid has emerged from these years of preparing and building as the most complete winter Olympic sports complex in the Western Hemisphere. The town is ready. The sports venues are ready. And the communication systems are ready for 1980. And I know each athlete is ready for that one special day, the chance to compete for the most prized athletic distinction of all, the Olympic gold medal, signifying the best in the world.